Welcome back, my loyal friends. The topic of today are obviously legs and more feet. I'm here to explain you what's the difference between these legs and the all feet that you see right here. There is a lot to say here. As you can see, we have two legs, 3 feet. Okay, two legs, 3 feet. How is that even possible? So those two legs are obviously very different. And then this is our third foot. So here we have two legs and 2 feet. And here we have 1 foot. Let's start from this leg. So this is a leg with the foot, okay? This is a socket and this is a foot. This is only a foot itself. I know it doesn't look like a normal foot with the toes, no, because this is specifically for running and jumping. You only want to run and jump with this one. This is a flex run by Osur. Mine is cut 3. What that means that this is designed for my weight, okay? I'm a woman, I weighed 64 kilos, about 143 pounds. And this is designed for that. I'm also a little heavier for this one. This goes until a maximum loading of 60 kilos. So if I want to give this away, or I want somebody use it and it's like heavy as 10 kilos more than me, more than this can absorb, it will break. It will literally break. And it won't be so useful. It won't give you enough energy back. So those are designing on your weight. So be aware of that, because it's important when you order with your prosthetist a foot, even this type of foot, you really need to be precise with your weight. And if you gain weight in the future, well, be careful, because the foot might not be for you anymore. Okay, so that's it. This foot is the balance foot, and it's a regular, simple, lighter also foot for walking, okay? This is a socket. So I'm gonna show you what that means. So now I'm gonna break down in 2 parts the whole leg. So now we have a socket, and now we have the other foot, okay? So this is the balance foot and has a foot shell. I will show you what's inside. I still have a sand. So this is how it look like, the balance foot inside the foot shell. This is called foot shell. And this is the foot, okay? So one more time, this foot doesn't come with this, but you also have to adjust this other part, which for me has to be on this height, but it depends how short is your stump. My stump is pretty long, it's a good size, not really short. So I need a lot of this. Okay, so when you buy a foot, it comes like that. and then your prosthetician adjust with your height, adjust with these other metallic parts. Okay, so now let's go back. Now this is not a leg anymore, we only have a foot and a socket. This is gonna be attached over here. Okay, now we have a leg. Now we have a leg for running and jumping. Okay, that's it. Feet and legs, all the whole piece together. Okay, now my socket has this valve. This is just like for have more suspension. So I have a vacuum system. My stamp will be vacuum inside the socket because I prefer that. But there are different systems. It depends on you, it depends how comfortable you are. Some other people, they don't use the valves. Some other people, they use the suspension sleeve. So it depends on you, it's very personal. Now let's talk about this leg. This is a uni leg. I look very different now. I cannot divide it. I cannot split this leg in two parts as I did with this one. I cannot do it. That's why it's called uni leg. It's only one piece. It's only one piece. There is no metal at all. So I don't need to use this key, this Halley key, and yeah, it also still has this the suspension for me with the valve, but you can also use the pin lock eventually. So this is not even a socket; it's just like the whole leg. It's a uni leg, and I love it because it's much lighter than this. It doesn't rust, it doesn't, you know, have any problem like this one. I can go have a shower, I can go to the beach, I can have a sand, nothing happened to this material. And obviously this also for walking. I usually also work out with this one, but I cannot lift a lot of weight because this leg also has a loading weight which cannot go over my weight plus other 20 pounds or so, 25 pounds. So I have to be careful as well, but that's it. This is just a uni leg, just a piece. And you know, it's very light, it's cool, and has a very different design, and it looks also way nicer on you when you wear that, and it's very comfortable. Me, what's best between this and that? I would prefer the uni leg because I feel it's more an extension of my stamp on my own leg. In this one, no, I can feel that I have two pieces on me and it's not the same. But again, this is very personal. This is very personal. So I always suggest talk to your doctor, talk to your prostheticians, because they can give you different feet to try, like that trial feet. And whatever you feel comfortable with, then I would suggest you to use that one for walking, because most of the time we need that foot for walk or for do our regular activity. Our other feet like for sports, but we don't use this all the time. So let me know if you have any other question about that, if something doesn't really convince you, or if there's something that you still don't understand. I'm here to respond to all your questions, and obviously sometimes awkward, sometimes it's very weird. I understand completely. It's not easy to figure it out what foot and what leg is good for you. That's why I opened this channel, that even if you don't have a prosthetic leg yet and you just go over a new surgery and you need support, don't hesitate, just ask me. Those are only few examples, but there are so many different feet, so many different categories, and it's still difficult for me as well, so I completely understand. Don't be shy, don't be scared. Don't be scared. If the amputation is the only solution for you, that's fine. It will take a little bit to adapt and adjust, but you will get there. You will get there, you will feel active and alive again. You will feel like you can do so many different things. So don't despair. We are here to help each other. Thank you, bye. See you in the next.